In this illustration, we'll be analyzing a cylinder rolling with an attached mass. Here we are given that a small mass m is attached to a ring of same mass and radius r. And here the ring rolls without sliding over a horizontal plane. And when the attached mass is at lowest position, ring center is moving at a speed v. And we are required to calculate at what maximum value of V the ring moves without bouncing. Now, in this situation, if we wish to calculate the situation when the ring is moving without bouncing, that means this mass M, when it reaches the top, till that instant normal reaction at bottom must not be zero. Because when this mass is revolving about the center, it will be experiencing relative centrifugal force in outward direction, and when the upward component of that centrifugal force exceeds the weight of a ring plus block, it may bounce. And to avoid bouncing, we can say when it reaches the top, till that moment, this normal reaction at the bottom must not be zero. So we can say if the ring is not bouncing, this implies till a small m reaches the topmost point, at ground, normal reaction should not be zero. We can say when it reaches topmost point, the normal reaction at the bottom should just be zero. That will be the speed at which it can move without bouncing. So in this situation, we can draw the case when the small m reaches the topmost point. The situation would be this. When the ring is moving and the small m mass reaches the topmost point, and at this instant, say the system is moving with a velocity v1, and in case of pure rolling, its angular speed will be v1 by r at this moment. So in this situation, we can write first the work energy equation to calculate the value of v1, and we can write if in the state when m is at top, velocity of ring is v1, we use the initial kinetic energy, we can write as half m v square plus its rotational kinetic energy in the ring is half mr square multiplied by v by r whole square. And we can ignore the kinetic energy in the bottom mass m because it is at the bottommost point, and in pure rolling we can say the bottom point is at rest. And when it reaches the topmost point, the work done by gravity is mg multiplied by 2r is equals to the final kinetic energy. Here we can write half mv1 square plus half mr square multiplied by v1 by r whole square plus the kinetic energy of this mass m, which would be moving at twice the speed in pure rolling at the topmost point. So it is half m multiplied by 2v1 square. If we simplify this relation, it gives us mv square minus 2mgr is equals to, this is mv1 square plus this will be 2mv1 square, and this will be, here you can see, this is also 2mv1 square. So this is 2mv1 square. Now in this term, if we calculate the value of v1 square, this gives us v square minus 2gr divided by 3. So we have got the value of a speed, and we can say at the position or state shown in figure if a ring is just bouncing. This implies, here we can write, for this system, the downward force acting on it is 2 mg, the weight of the system. Here, if we draw the free body diagram, there will be 1 mg on the ring and 1 mg on the block. A normal reaction is acting up, and this M will be experiencing a centrifugal force with respect to center, that is mv1 square by r. Here you can see, we are drawing this force, centrifugal force, relative to C, where C is the center of this ring. So, here we can write, at the position shown in figure, with respect to ring center, here we can write, 2mg minus n should be equals to mv1 square by r, and here n is just becoming 0 for just the state of bouncing, and physically there is no separation between the contacts. So, here we can write, the value we are getting is 2mg is equals to m by r multiplied by v square. V1 square we can write as V square minus 2GR by 3. And on simplifying this, we'll get the value of V, that is root of 8GR, that is the result of this problem.